केसी रामामूर्ति जी, श्री केसी रामामूर्ति जी,
Madam, I'm sorry for this. Madam, while supporting the bill, I would like to highlight a few points for consideration of the government. In the statement of objects and reasons, it is very clearly mentioned that the bill aims to address one, undue delay, second, relief of payers, and third, to discourage frivolous and unnecessary litigation. Madam, the main object of the government is to reduce pendency of the cheque bouncing cases. But will the Honourable Minister clarify whether with the proposed amendment the cheque bounce cases would come down? I doubt it very much. Unless and until you have stronger deterrence, it is not possible. I'll give an example of France. In France, if anyone defaults on cheque payments, he will be added to a central cheque register known as FCC, and once a person's name is included in this, he is barred from issuing cheques for 5 years. This kind of stringent provision could have been included in the amendment, which would have worked as a deterrent to the people. Madam, as per one estimate, there are as many as 16 lakh cheque bounce cases pending in subordinate courts and more than 35,000 cases in higher courts. In Karnataka alone, out of 7 lakh criminal cases, 3 lakhs are under Negotiable Instrument Act. This amendment will not solve the problem in any manner, since the number of pending cases is mounting and the time taken for disposal of these cases is increasing day by day. It is mandated that cases are summary trials in 6 months, but in practice, it is not happening. There is a need for the government to have an impact assessment of pendency and devise ways and means for faster disposal of cases, which is now not happening. So whatever is proposed to do with this amendment is only a piecemeal solution to benefit mainly the complainant. Madam, the proposed amendment provides for depositing the amount within 2 months. If the deposit is not made within the prescribed 2 months, the complainant has to request the court to initiate coercive measures to deposit a said amount, which would result in a tedious and time-consuming process. The courts, after having awarded the interim compensation, would have to direct the complainant to refund the said amount in case of an acquittal. If the complainant does not repay the said amount, the accused will have to move for recovery of the said amount, perhaps by moving recovery proceedings, which is again a cumbersome process, and that would put the accused into hardship and inconvenience. The proposed amendment, madam, would amount to multiplicity of proceedings, particularly given the fact that most of the cheque dishonor cases have been false prosecutions, majority resulting in acquittals in recent times, and hence would complicate the process and drag the court proceedings for a considerable amount of time, and would also increase the number of pendency cases in the courts, much against the very objective of the bill. Most importantly, madam, all of us are aware that the amendment is and will be more beneficial to the financial institutions, money lenders and traders. But the people who borrow money generally are financially and economically weak and poor people. Their payment capacity will also be limited. Most of the time, the lenders will obtain blank checks or post-dated checks beforehand only, and since under Section 17 of the Act, it is the holder in due course has to proceed, but in reality, anybody can fill up the check, present the check, which will already would have signatures of the drawer. Since it is going to be a blank check, the amount that is going to be entered may be totally different than the agreed amount. Unless we make possession of blank checks with signatures of unconnected persons an offense, there will be no protection for the person who issues the check. Madam, recently, I would like to bring to the knowledge of the House, in Bangalore, in one of the Bangalore social club's locker, they have seized hundreds of blank checks. Hundreds of blank checks have been seized along with huge cash. So that is an indication that the money lenders and the financial institutions are using this provision to their advantage. Madam, the bill is silent when a drawer commits offence repeatedly. As per the provisions, the same procedure would be followed, which I think is not appropriate. So I suggest for consideration of the Honourable Minister that if the drawer commits offences repeatedly, the deposit amount from 20% going to 30% to 40% or 50%, then there will be some sort of a deterrence. This will create a lot of agony in spite of getting himself the, I'm talking about the persons, you know, who deposit the money, the accused. If he doesn't get that money, he will have to face a lot of inconvenience. So care should be taken in this regard, and at least bank guarantee must be taken from the person. The 20% money you give, the case gets acquitted, then to recover that money, this person will have to suffer a lot. So at least a bank guarantee should be taken from the person who receives 20% amount, so that the recovery will be much easier. I suggest for consideration, Honourable Minister, to fix a time period also within which cases have to be disposed of. It can be 3 months or a maximum period of 6 months. For this, we need to constitute fast-track courts, arrange for alternative dispute resolution forums, without which it is not possible to get justice at all. More importantly, Madam, I also feel that the conflicting interests must be properly balanced and fine-tuned to protect the innocent borrowers also, who generally belong to, as I told earlier, middle class or lower middle class or economically weaker section of the society. However, I would also like to mention that this amendment has very many positive outcomes also. The relevant provisions of the income tax mandate, where payment exceeding ₹20,000 should be brought in so that this cash transactions is totally reduced. The presumptions available under Section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act cannot be blown out of proportion if we don't invoke this ₹20,000 ceiling that is fixed by the Income Tax Department. Due to the fact that such interim compensation could be awarded at a very initial stage, the drawer of the cheque would be careful and conscious before issuing such cheques randomly to the payee. The provisions of the interim compensation and condition in making appeals will not only act as a deterrent against the drawer of the cheque, but will also give some relaxation to the payees in terms of realizing his money. But the bill has made a provision to deposit 20% of the amount of cheque immediately without considering the case where the dishonor of the cheque might have not been caused deliberately. Only one more minute, Madam. Apart from this, sufficient infrastructure will have to be created, developed in the courts to deal with these cases. As the government pushes for a cashless economy, it is very, very important to deal with the menace in a comprehensive manner, not in a peaceful manner, as I suggested already. Thank you very much for the time.